morning. It's a pleasure to be with you, HR leaders and people holding a leadership role in companies. Welcome to our channel, MEHR's People Innovations, a channel which will help you learn path-breaking practices in HRM and leadership. This week's Learning Bite in HRM and leadership is the top three trends that transform recruitment. Recruitment is a very, very critical function, both for you leaders as well as the HR community. It's the one source by which you can get high quality talent into your organization, and 90% of your battle is won if you get the right people in the right place. So how does technology transform recruitment? Let's look at what some of the companies are doing in this space. The first trend I'm going to talk about is the usage of machine learning. We all know what machine learning is. Basically, the ability to look for repetitive patterns using text parsing, voice parsing, etc. How is it being used in recruitment? Now, let's see how machine learning is changing recruitment, at least at the sourcing stage. When you started, at least when I started, I should say, some of you may be much younger, when I started in the 90s, how did we do sourcing? We used to download resumes or get resumes physically, prepare a shortlisting checklist, mechanically take out specific data, how many years of experience, what degree, blah, 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 and it used to take at least 5 to 10 minutes to read a resume and put it down in your Excel sheet. Now, once you put it down in a sheet, a spreadsheet, you would then use this to now create a form or some kind of response sheet, and then select the people that you're going to respond to and the people you're not going to respond to. It was a very time-consuming process. Today, what is happening is we are slowly moving into a few technologies. First is a slightly older technology, which many of the companies have already gone through, which is called a weighted selection form. What was a weighted selection form? It was essentially a form which sat on your website. It was also called a weighted employment blank. You fill in that form and automatically it sorts out the forms. For example, let's say it asks you a question like, so as you go on to the website and fill in the form, you will be asked a question, did you apply to a company for the last 6 months? If you said yes, it will ask you the date or month in which you applied and then give you a date after which you can apply. This was a software which basically checks certain things and gives certain simple responses. Pretty simple. Companies like Google, etc. obviously have to use it. Imagine they get 2 million job applicants every year. Do you think somebody can physically go through each and every resume? They'll go mad. Even if it takes 5 minutes or 10 minutes per resume, that will be 20 million minutes spent on just sorting out resumes. So they just can't do it. So these companies, what they do is, they essentially build a particular form, and a lot of automation is done at the time of website. Today we have gone much beyond this. If you go back and see 2010, what is really happening? Completely something new. What is happening is many of the companies are starting to use what we traditionally have called AI. AI to do what? Machine learning to look for certain patterns. If you know that certain people have lied in the resume and there is a particular type of phrase that they use, for example, many of the very experienced IT professionals will say, if somebody says they have done a hospital management system and they have done it within 3 months or 6 months, it's probably a fake because they probably went to an institute, did it as a dummy project, and they're claiming it to be a real project. Now, these kind of repetitive patterns can be searched using machine learning. Many of the new time startups are using these technologies. Now, once you sort it out, you can use blockchain technology to automate certain responses and check certain things. So these kind of technologies are becoming heavily used in recruitment. Trend 2, gamification and augmented reality techniques used in recruitment. This is a very fascinating area, and quite a few companies are doing a lot of work in it. Let's name a couple. For example, some companies are using it to check motivation for the job. Are you really going to be suitable for the job? Do you have a natural aptitude for certain jobs? And they will let people get a feel of the job before you take up the job. Now, let's say I want you to be a bus driver. And if you really become a bus driver and you find the traffic too much to handle, especially in a city like Hyderabad, it will be a waste of our time to recruit you. But if I put you in an augmented reality device for 2 hours and I see how you behave, I can judge this. This sounds a lot of mumbo jumbo, especially since the Hyderabad RTO or Road Transport Authority doesn't use any augmented reality, but there are companies which are using it. Let's look at a couple. Marriott Hotels does a very, very interesting app. It's called My Marriott Hotel. What happens is people are put through a simulated environment and you can play it like a game. You can kind of do your planning for your restaurant. You can check how you satisfy your customers. And obviously people who do well may have a natural aptitude. And also people who do well may say, hey, this might be something I enjoy doing, and take it up as a full-time career. So it's used to motivate people to apply to Marriott. It also creates a natural selection process even before the candidate comes. Another company organization which really does this really well is for looking at the kind of training for applicants to experience how it feels. So they do a virtual reality of, let's say, how do you feel to drive a trike? How do you feel if you do mountaineering? And they can see how well you are reacting. So again, it motivates you and it allows you to identify those candidates who may be having a natural aptitude. The last and final trend, which is fairly well known, but I just want to highlight it because it's a critical trend, is HR analytics. The usage of analytics in recruitment has really changed and revolutionized recruitment. A couple of quick examples. Where is it being used? It's basically to check and get a better idea as to which characteristics to look for using techniques like predictive analytics. Let's take a simple example, couple of quick examples. It is used, for example, Google uses analytics. It's almost become synonymous, right? Google and analytics. But of course, they do analytics in recruitment. And how do they do it? They have identified which characteristics enhance or look for good job performance. So if you say, what are those characteristics you look for in a candidate, you might be mistaken. For example, if you say, I feel this characteristics may be important. This may be important. It's a huge waste of time. So Google has established through a quantitative analysis that ability to take a job is a very good predictor for high performance once they join. In fact, Middle Earth we ourselves have done a very large analytics project to identify for our sales team what characteristics are good for a sales team. We initially used to think that characteristics like group communication or product knowledge in HR may be useful for salespeople or may be critical determinants for job performance. We realized these are not so critical. They're easily trainable and they're not critical. The critical characteristics when we did a Pearson's correlation study was between listening skills and performance. Therefore, we changed our recruitment process to identify listening skills as part of our process, and that became a critical component of our recruitment process. Doing this, we found we were able to get better quality of candidates. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this learning bite. It's short and sweet, but I hope it will give you some good impetus to learn some new things which will be really helpful in a job. So with that, let me end by saying thank you for listening. And if you love this video and you felt you would like to get more of this video in your inbox on a weekly basis free of charge, all you need to do is subscribe to our channel. So guys, that's the box, right? The bell icon. Please press it and subscribe. But if you really want to know more about analytics, we have a great program in HR Analytics. Visit our website, find out about it. If you want us to consult with you, well, the same thing, visit our website and inquire. Thanks, guys. Bye.